Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Plan B Success. Do you live to work or work to live? Have you asked yourself that question and found your answer? Are you tied to your job and spend innumerable hours on it since you're so passionate about it? Or do you find yourself unable to separate from it due to your incessant need to work to put the other aspects of your life from falling apart? In either case, you're perhaps not truly engaged in your work, but are consumed by it so you can make ends meet or perhaps keep yourself away from things you want to avoid. Whether passion overtakes you or when your needs force you to keep at the job, you tend to burn out and your work-life balance is threatened. Either way, when you live to work or work to live, the balance is so subtle that you can do away with your sense of fulfillment and accomplishment. You do not act out of joy or to elicit joy. You're more under stress, trying to perform and prove a point. Whether you enjoy your work or perform because you have to, it's important to draw a line where you disengage from it at the right times and find your life away from your work. For many, the lines between working and living are so blurred that they let each mix with the other. Ever found yourself answering emails or text messages late at night? Now that's what blurring those lines of work-life balance feels like. And it all begins with you. You taking a stand to delineate your work from your life. Work is and should always be a means to an end. Does this mean it takes away from you being engaged when at work? Not necessarily. It means giving your work and your life the respect and place they deserve. When at work, of course, be engaged and engrossed so you put in your best. And when away from it, totally detach yourself and get engrossed in your life. Being disengaged at work is a common problem. And the reason for that is you allowing work and life to cross paths and take over. As a result, you may feel trapped and want to get out. And before you know, disillusionment takes over. Disengagement tends to linger when someone goes through the motions of their work or life out of obligation and nothing more. It kills the unique difference you make to your work or life. Guard your zeal as fiercely as you possibly can. When you're too reliant on your work to feel worthy, you tend to rely heavily on it to find worth in your own eyes. As a result, you may shut out other opportunities that can bring out facets of your personality. It can lead to premature burnout, taking a toll on your physical health and mental well-being. When you align your work and career with your likes, talents, and natural abilities, you tend to hold off burnout longer. As someone who lives to work, you could always be triggered by the need to perform better, deliver continuously and consistently, and in the process stress yourself out. All this is important, but in a way where you find meaning in what you do and deliver, and extend that meaning into other parts of your life. Ask yourself if this is what you want to do, if you find happiness and fulfillment, and if it helps you find richness in your other aspects of life. You may be someone who associates very closely with your work and have a need to accomplish better than yesterday, and also better than others. Nothing wrong with that. But you may also be someone who wants to find time to spend with your family, your kids, your friends, perhaps read a book or watch a play. Do not push the latter out so you can focus more on the former. Make time now. You'll be glad you did, since it'll affect your work as well as your overall life. Any modern organization out there recognizes the need and importance of employee engagement to drive performance. But they also recognize the need for a work-life balance. As an entrepreneur or an employee, you need to understand where that level of engagement lies for you. Identify your challenges in maintaining that balance and work on smoothing them out. While living to work or working to live both have their pros and cons, the control of how you see your work-life balance lies with you. Take control and ensure you find the middle ground where you're engaged, contributing, and enjoy a work-life balance that provides you with the energy to carry on successfully and find fulfillment. Hey, I hope you liked that episode. Please do check out Plan B Success Podcast on your favorite listening platforms. It's also available on www.planb.live. If you're looking to learn how to podcast and learn everything there is to ideate, create, launch, and monetize a podcast, do get in touch through the website www.planb.live. And I'll be more than happy to help. Thank you very much.